Hello everyone, welcome you all. I Pankaj Chawla. We will together learn more topics related to electrical engineering and many algorithms used in research field and more general important topics to keep update your knowledge. Our channel especially focus on how to transfer book knowledge into practical or presentable way so everyone easily learn. Today we will discuss how to obtain a step response of a control system in MATLAB software and analyze it further. Let's start with a control system. A control system is a combination of elements arranged in a planned manner wherein each element cause and effect to produce a desired output. This cause and effect relationship is governed by a mathematical model. Definition states that control plus system become a control system. A proper arrangement of element is known as a system. इसको एक example से समझते हैं. A fan is a simple system. For a fan, we have an input 230 volt AC supply, get an output as an air flow. When a fan is combined with a regulator, it become a control system. For a same input, we get a desired air flow. Mathematical model to represent system is termed as transfer function. For a system, we have input, we have output. Output upon input relation is known as transfer function. To study the transfer function, we have a step response. A step response is the time response of the system or plant for a step input. To study the behavior of the plant or system, a step response is required. These are some standard step response we obtain as an output when step is given as an input to the system. To study the step response, we have some parameter like rise time, peak overshoot, settling time. Now to move forward, to learn more about step response, how to obtain step response in MATLAB. Before that, we have to learn how to obtain a transfer function in MATLAB. For the same, we have to consider a typical mathematical model of any control system in SDOMIAN. So this is a typical example of mathematical representation of a system. In a system, we have input, output, forward function, feedback function, as GS, HS respectively represented in figure. As we already discussed, transfer function is represented by a ratio of output upon input, and there is a standard formula to evaluate transfer function, that is GS upon 1 plus GS, HS for negative feedback. By simply putting value of GS, HS, we get transfer function 16 upon S square plus 1.6 S plus 16. So now we have a mathematical equation of transfer function of a system considered for further evaluation. Now we have learned how to obtain a transfer function in MATLAB. Now we move towards MATLAB programming. To evaluate transfer function and step response in MATLAB coding, there may be two different methods to evaluate transfer function. We will discuss both methods one by one, then you adopt one of the methods for further study as per your convenience. In MATLAB, we will use some commands to calculate transfer function and step response. Firstly, we understand here, then just copy it on MATLAB platform to code it in MATLAB. From assume problem, we have forward function as GS and feedback function as HS. We will write the coefficient of numerator denominator of GS as shown. In numerator, we have only one coefficient, that is 16. In denominator, we have equation S square plus 1.6 S. Then its coefficient are arranged in descending order as 1, 1.6, 0. 0 represent that there is no constant term present in the denominator. Same for HS, we have 1 by 1 as a coefficient. Then use feedback command to evaluate numerator and denominator coefficient of complete system. Then use transfer function command termed as TF to evaluate transfer function of system and assigned in sys variable. And finally, we get transfer function in MATLAB as shown value of sys variable. Now open a MATLAB and let's see how we work over here. When you open a MATLAB, once this is the layout of MATLAB, we can write a program on command window itself.
This space is used for command window and complete our task, but later you can't save it. So it's better we will write a code in script file, also known as editor file. In home tab, you find the option of open new script file like this. Then write a code in the file and save it for further use also. Script file save in current folder. If you want to change the location of save your file, you can change path of current folder. This is the option of browse current folder. Whenever you run your script file, output will be at command window. Save and run option available in editor tab. This is the option of saving and there is the option of run file. To understand easily and keep more emphasis on understanding, I already created a document and saved it. So let's start to understand program. First two lines are used to put comment for better understanding. Simply percentage sign is used to create a comment line. As we already discussed, numerator and denominator variables are used to put coefficient of GS and HS. Then we use three or two basic command before writing a code, just to avoid any type of error or clashing in variable values, like close all to close already open files, clear all to clear all variables, clc to clear command window. Generally, it's a good habit to use these commands in the beginning of code. Then we assign values in variable, as we already discussed in detail on PPT. Same assign values here in variables. Then use feedback command to evaluate coefficient of system, and then use tf command to evaluate transfer function of system, and assign value in sys variable. When you run it, you will get output at command window. As we all know that the transfer function of our system is 16 upon s square plus 1.6s plus 16. So we get same over here. Now simply we use one more command, that is a step command like this, and then again run the same file and we get step response of the system in the graphical form. So let's see how measure parameter on it. Just right click on a graph. You have options in which one option is characteristic. In that you have option like peak response, settling time, rise time, steady state. Select all option one by one. And you have a mark for each on a graph as you see. Move your cursor to observe the value for each, as it give rise time equal to 0.301 second, peak amplitude 1.53 at 0.806 second, settling time 4.9 second, and obvious steady state value equal to 1 as a step input given. So now you all know the process of obtaining step response of given problem in MATLAB and evaluate its parameter. Hope you enjoy learning with me. We discussed small aspect of problem and do some exercise on MATLAB. As I told you that there may be a two methods of obtaining step response in MATLAB. So we will discuss another process and more concept related to it in next video. Till keep practice on MATLAB. MATLAB is one of the best tool in research field. I deliver also online lectures on MATLAB basic to familiar you with MATLAB tools.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel, and also press the bell icon as we keep on posting informative content like this. You can also get certification from Tishitu Research Center if you finish minimum of 10 videos from the playlist. To get more information about this, connect to us at tishitu@gmail.com.